Hey everybody, it's Christina of Crafty Paws. I wanted to share with you guys a little drawing that I did. This is for Robin, TNGirl224, here on YouTube. She asked that I do a drawing of her adorable little girl, Zoe, who's a Brewer Terrier, I think it is. I'd never heard of that breed before, and I at first thought Zoe was a Havanese, like my little bandito. But you can tell the ears are different. These ears are, Zoe's ears are shorter and cropped shorter. The fur is shorter. And the coloring is a little different, although you can't really tell on a black and white ink drawing like this. So I normally don't take commissions for drawings. I'm physically not able to do that right now. But Robin is such a sweetheart, and she supports so many charities, including animal shelters, and she always participates in Beth's Scrapbook Room's charitable initiatives, and she was so sweet and sent all these adorable little puppy clothes for my local animal shelter, and she's just an amazing, generous, warm person, and I know she's going through some things right now. I don't know the details, and I don't need to know, but I hoped that these drawings would bring her some joy, and so I alluded to drawings. I decided, after doing this ink drawing, that I really wanted to do a colorful one. So I took this drawing, and I scanned it into my computer, and I decided I was going to do one colored up. So this is the colored version of that. And I did take some photos from Robin of her dogs, and so I could see the color shading variations. You know, pictures don't really show the real colors very well, so I examined a variety of pictures, and I did want to give some more clarity to Zoe's eyes than some of the pictures would indicate. So I did these, and I glossy accented the eyes and her nose, and of course I blinged up her little crown, little pink bling, and those were given to me by Brittany Pachik, and they were just the perfect size. Thank you, Brittany. And I just added some colors that I thought would be warm, and hopefully it'll coordinate with something in your house, Robin. I don't know. I ended up coloring everything up with my little 12-pack of Derwent Ink Tests watercolor pencils. Even with just 12 colors, I mean, I'd love to have more, but even with just 12, it is fantastic. You can get so many color variations just by mixing with water and mixing different layers. I layered up two colors up here, the blue and the pink or magenta. I don't remember the color name exactly. And I actually like the texture that stays with using it on matte photo paper. If you use it on a watercolor paper, it blends more fully, but I actually like this texture that remains from the actual pencil marks, the strokes. And then over top, I just thought it'd be cute if I added some little bones. So I took the tiny little bone stamp that I got from Jill, Love My Two Pugs One, thank you, Jill, and I just stamped out with white ink over top of the blues and the pinks to create kind of like a wallpaper effect back there. And I like how it turned out. And Robin, I hope you like these drawings and that they bring you some joy. I really enjoyed making them for you. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. I hope you guys are having a great weekend or whatever day you're watching. Bye.